Well, thanks for staying with us. Have you ever heard of TIAs? Well, TIA stands for transient ischemic attack. I got that right. I had to practice that. And they used to be regarded as mini strokes, but not anymore. But they are a major warning sign that a stroke could occur. So joining us today to tell us more is Diane Handler. She's the stroke coordinator at Mercy Medical Center in Cedar Rapids. So thanks for joining us. And maybe you can kind of fill us in on what is a TIA and how does it indicate that a stroke might actually happen?
All right. Well, a TIA, transient ischemic attack, basically is when there is a clot that has formed within a blood vessel of the brain, and for some reason it breaks up. And so the symptoms that, you know, were with the clot, you know, that were with the blockage, go away. And it's transient. It's typically less than 1 hour.
Okay.
And what we have found, though, is that if the clot lasts for longer than 1 hour, people probably did have an actual stroke.
Okay. And that would be the symptoms of, like, you know, the numbness or loss of feeling.
Numbness or weakness on one side.
Okay.
Another symptom may be vision changes, maybe dizziness. It could be the inability to speak clearly or confusion, things like that. Those are many of the symptoms of stroke. And it just depends on where, you know, where it affects the brain.
And what are the chances that if you have one of these TIA events, what are the chances that you would actually have a stroke in the future?
Well,
are they more increased?
Yeah, it's very, very interesting. 8% of people that may have a TIA will go on to have a full stroke within 1 week, and within 3 months, 20% of people may go on to have a full stroke. So it really affects about a third of the people with TIAs.
Now, are there tests that you can do with this, like screenings, CAT scans, or something like that, that can detect it?
Well, we really like for people to come to the hospital if they have TIAs, because at that point we'll look at their carotid arteries through carotid Doppler studies. We'll look at their heart rhythm. Sometimes variations in heart rhythm can cause clotting. We can do a head CT or an MRI to see if there's actual stroke damage there.
Okay.
And of course, we want to test their cholesterol to see if they have high cholesterol. So those are some of the tests that would be run.
So we hear a lot about, you know, heart attack symptoms and things like that, clots and blockages like that, that can also cause strokes. What are some of the other symptoms that you might be on the lookout for risk factors even for TIA?
Well, risk factors for TIA, clearly if people smoke, or if they do not exercise, if they eat inappropriately or just not, you know, not great food, that would be a risk factor for stroke. Also, risk factors that we could control is if someone has high blood pressure, if they have diabetes, if someone has heart irregularities, like a rhythm called atrial fibrillation, they are at a much higher risk for stroke than people that don't have that. Also, age, of course, is something we can't control.
Right.
And but as we get older, we get more clots or more plaque buildup within our blood vessels, and that's why we have a more higher incidence of heart attack as well as stroke.
Okay. Well, there's an event coming up. If you'd like to learn more about TIA, it's coming up on April 24th. It's over the lunch hour from 12 to 1 at the Iowa Works Meeting Room at Lindale Mall. Go in on the lower level. And if you'd like to learn more, mercycare.org/events. Check that out. Thanks
Thank
so much
you.
For being here
appreciate
and helping us fill in on this important topic. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you.